When you have followed my YouTube channel, you will surely know that I was busy with this circuit. It's a 12-stage ripple counter. And I have to say that I know more or less almost nothing from these kinds of circuits. My focus was always and is always on analog electronics anyway. So this is for me, was for me a very interesting new experiment. And I found quite a few things. Perhaps it's interesting to show them. And this is my first experiment. You can see all these beautiful LEDs flickering. And this is, as far as I know, a counter. But it is also a kind of a bucket memory, where we send in here a pulse of a certain time. That pulse goes through all these, say, buckets, where that charge passes, etc., etc. There are also Schmitt triggers in action, and it means that here we have, say, the input frequency, and here, say, the on pin 11. The lowest frequency that this ripple counter can give. And I was very surprised by a few things. At first, I found that, put on the lights, I found that I did not need a clock generator to drive this chip. It is so extremely sensitive, and I think it has everything to do with, say, the static, the way that the CMOS works. It works or can work with static charges to drive, to be driven. And in this case, I've used a piece of wire as a clock input via a 10k resistor that is here. And this is the piece of wire. In fact, we have to do with an antenna. And that antenna picks up a frequency. And in the Netherlands, we have 50 hertz on the mains supply. So my my idea was that this antenna could pick up 50 hertz and use that as a clock input to the chip. But I was very surprised to see this on the scope. And this is not 50 hertz, but it is 25 hertz. I don't have a real good explanation for that anyway. But the interesting thing was, here we have 25 hertz, but on output 2 we have half of that. It is 12.5 hertz. On pin 3 it is again divided, and on pin 4, output pin 4, it is again further divided, and so we go on and on. And on pin 11, once in 20 seconds the LED lights up. You can do that experiment yourself. Here is how I made it. These are the bright red LEDs. They are connected to all the output pins. They are here. Via a 3K resistor, clock input is that antenna that picks up, say, 50 hertz in the room where I live. And also interesting, there is here that pin, that override pin, say, a kind of reset pin. And that also works when you touch that pin with your hand. Well, let me show it. I now touch that override pin. So all the LEDs, the whole ID stops. The antenna, of course, receives still 50 hertz or a certain frequency. But here it can be stopped. So what's the use of this, say, first experiment? Of course, it's interesting, perhaps, that you can use such a setup to make a kind of clock. And in that case, of course, don't use this antenna. That's only, say, a simple first ID to get a little bit insight in such a chip. But anyway, you can surely see that when you push in on pin 1 a certain frequency, it's divided to a lower frequency. So every, say, 19 seconds or 20 seconds, this LED lights up. Of course, you can also use it as a Christmas gift. And that's the reason why you see all these beautiful LEDs flickering. I put out all the LEDs now. It works very, very nice. And of course you have to use that antenna, a small piece of wire hanging in your room, and then you will perhaps also see all these LEDs flickering in this way. And when you have to do with people knowing nothing about electronics, could be very interesting for them. When they touch here the circuit, everything stops. I'm going to put out all the lights in the room, because in that case you can surely see that it is such a circuit is usable, say, as a fantasy Christmas light, etc., etc. And also, it's very interesting to see how the memory, how the buckets with charge are pushed through the chip, to go to all the output pins. And that's the ID. And when you study the data sheet, you'll surely see that. But now you see it in practice. Anyway, thanks for watching. Pan over somewhat. My camera starts to flicker. So I have to be very, very short. So the start-stop switch, the say antenna wire used as a clock. Had not expected that anyway. Here that circuit again, but I have already showed it. So again, thanks for watching. And let's look at this beautiful, oh, beautiful sight again. It's fun. It shows that electronics is fun.